The Lord be with you. Good morning and welcome to worship on this 19th Sunday after Pentecost, October 3rd, 2021. I'm Pastor Matt Smith from Bethlehem Evangelical Lutheran Church in Lansing, Michigan. Today's service will include hymns and songs, an anthem led by members of our choir, a children's sermon, and my sermon titled The Breath of Life, and readings and prayers from our assisting minister today, Don Tellis. Today is the first Sunday of the month, and so we will receive a special second offering for the Greater Lansing Food Bank and our food pantry. You may have seen a slide cycling through or received in the mail a letter about our Going Live appeal, trying to gather support from the congregation for us to purchase all of the equipment, the cameras and sound equipment and computers that we need and able to live stream our services. This is not a live stream. I'm recording this before producing. I record all my parts on Friday usually, but I'll get into more of that a little bit later. So I hope that you are considering supporting us so that we can go live and gather together fully as a congregation, some worshiping virtually, some worshiping in person. Today's gospel combines a saying that makes us uncomfortable with a story that we find comforting. Jesus saying on divorce and other of his rejections of human sin, of human legislation, his rejection of that in favor of the original intent of God's law can be uncomfortable. Jesus' rebuke of the disciples who are fending off children so that he can welcome them fully as God welcomes them fully in the kingdom, well, that's comforting. What does it mean for us to receive the kingdom of God as a child does? Now please join us for our confession and forgiveness.
Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, whose teaching is life, whose presence is sure, and whose love is endless. Amen. Jesus Christ is our High Priest. By his blood we have confidence to enter the sanctuary. Then let us approach with a true heart in full assurance of faith. Let us confess our sins and seek God's forgiveness. O God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, we confess to you our disobedience and our unworthiness. Without your mercy, we would be doomed on the day of judgment. Forgive us for taking our relationships too lightly, for treating those close to us with coldness, for treating the stranger with contempt. We have not loved wholeheartedly. We have not guarded our words as we should. We have refused to let the interest of others interfere with our own self-interest. Teach us through the example of Jesus how to love, how to share, how to be in community with others. For the sake of Jesus Christ, your obedient and worthy Son, we ask your forgiveness.
In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for you. He became the source of eternal salvation for all who obey him. For his sake, your sins are forgiven. The one who promised is faithful. We will hold fast to the confession of our hope without wavering. Jesus Christ is our great High Priest. Thanks be to God. Amen. And we sing, Let the Whole Creation Cry.
Thank you.
grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty and loving God, you have called us to be your children, and you would bless the world through our lives if we would only let you. Help us to open our hearts to your rule, O God, and to obey your commands. This we pray through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. He lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Now we invite children who are worshiping with us virtually to come focus on their screens for our worship talk for children. Good morning. I hope you're all doing well this morning. It's great to be able to be with you virtually. Question for you today. Who got this set up so that you could see the service on your television or computer or tablet or even phone? Who set that up for you? Who brought you to church virtually? Well, I bet your parents did, or maybe you needed to help your parents or grandparents get it figured out so that so that you could all be together in worship, so you could all come and hear the word of God and be with this community of faith. Well, it's great that someone cares about you enough to want you to go to church. And that tells me that the people who take care of you want to make sure that you learn about Jesus and his love for you. And the Bible tells us about a time that Jesus was teaching his disciples, and a large crowd of people, a bunch of people, were there to hear what he was saying. And as Jesus was teaching, people started bringing their children to him so that he could touch them, so that he could bless them. And the disciples didn't like these children interrupting Jesus. And they told people to get the children away, to take the children away. What do you think about that? The disciples telling people, take the children away. Well, Jesus was pretty upset about this and says, let the children come to me and do not stop them. The kingdom of heaven belongs to these little ones. And then Jesus took the children in his arms and blessed them. So let's always remember how Jesus loved children and took them into his arms, into his loving arms. We're thankful for each one of you who is able to tune in to our services, and thankful for the parents, grandparents, other loved ones who might have helped to get this set up so that we could all worship together. Let us pray. Repeat after me, okay? Dear God, we want to love your children just as Jesus loved them. Thank you that these children are gathered together today. And thank you that they have someone who loves them enough to bring them to Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, thank you for coming to pay attention to this, and I hope to see you all again soon.
Our first reading today is from Genesis, the second chapter, verses 18 through 24. When God finished his creation, he had man name all the creatures. Then God declares that the man should not have to live alone and creates a partner and helpmate. This is the biblical foundation of marriage. A reading from Genesis. The Lord God said, "It is not good that the man should be alone. I will make him a helper as his partner." So out of the ground, the Lord God formed every animal of the field and every bird of the air, and brought them to the man to see what he would call them. And whatever the man called every living creature, that was its name. The man gave names to all cattle, and to the birds of the air, and to every animal of the field. But for the man, there was not found a helper as his partner. So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man, and as he slept, then he took one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. And the rib that the Lord God had taken from the man, he made into a woman, and brought her to the man. Then the man said, "This at last is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman, for out of man this one was taken. Therefore a man leaves his father and his mother and clings to his wife, and they become one flesh." Word of God, word of life.
Are you your
our gospel reading from the Gospel of Mark, Jesus puts a high standard on marriage and a particularly high standard on the care and nurture of children. Here, he treats children as full human beings loved by God. The Holy Gospel according to Mark. Glory to you, O Lord. Some Pharisees came, and to test Jesus, they asked, "Is it lawful for a man to divorce his wife?" He answered them, "What did Moses command you?" They said, "Moses allowed a man to write a certificate of dismissal and to divorce her." But Jesus said to them, "Because of your hardness of heart, he wrote this commandment for you. But from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no one separate." Then in the house, the disciples asked him again about this matter. He said to them, "Whoever divorces his wife and marries another commits adultery against her, and if she divorces her husband and marries another, she commits adultery." People were bringing little children to him in order that he might touch them, and the disciples spoke sternly to them. But when Jesus saw this, he was indignant and said to them, "Let the little children come to me, and do not stop them. For it is to such as these that the kingdom of God belongs. Truly I tell you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God as a little child will never enter it." And he took them up in his arms, laid his hand on them, and blessed them. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. I bring you grace, peace, and love in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Just breathe. You know, that might be some of the best advice ever given, certainly some of the best advice I've ever received. Just breathe. Well, before I begin my abbreviated sermon, I need to take a few minutes to address our going live appeal, which many of you have had questions about. Thriving Beyond is what our focus is, and the third part of Thriving Beyond is to rise up. Going live is certainly rising up. We need to purchase improved sound equipment in order to go live. New sound equipment, cameras, computers to run the live stream, all of this so that we can worship together as one family with a group of folks worshiping virtually at the same time as people worshiping in person. This video gets recorded usually on Fridays. Sometimes it needs to happen on Thursday or even as late as Saturday morning, but it doesn't happen on Sunday, because I have 8 to 12 hours of production time after everything gets recorded in order to put the whole service together and set it up to go live on Facebook and YouTube. So I record my parts of the service very early, and anything that happens between the recording of me recording my parts of worship and the assisting minister recording their parts, anything that happens in the country or in our congregation and our community, that doesn't get included in the video. If we were live streaming our Sunday services, we would be one community in worship. And whatever happened in worship, we would all be part of that together, hearing God's word proclaimed as one body, hearing the message of the hymns, singing them when we're able to in person, and certainly you can sing along at home. Now, if we were live streaming last week in our in-person worship, Lori Weibel played her guitar for the first time in worship. She didn't sing, but played her guitar along with the recordings of singing for the first time since March of 2020. It was a joyful, celebratory moment. And because we're not live streaming, people who watch our worship video weren't able to embrace that and be part of that moment. Well, a letter was sent out to the congregation, and it's also on the cover of our October newsletter, and it addresses some of the whys, but surely it does not answer all of your questions. Our mutual ministry committee met on Thursday night this week, last night, as I'm recording this. Our mutual ministry committee is a committee of people made up of the current president of our congregation, that's Lori Weibel, the current council chair, that's Lisa Whitman, and the three past presidents. Now, some of those past presidents are no longer with us, so the bylaws allow the pastor to add whomever he would like to invite, he or she would like to invite, to serve on the committee. And so we have Jim Whitman, who is our most recent past president, serves on the Mutual Ministry Committee. Susan Mahoney is serving on our Mutual Ministry Committee, as well as Jack Midgley. And then I am present, as well as Pastor John Burrow, the retired assistant to the pastor. So we gathered together last night to address questions, and that's why I'm taking time during this video recording, rather than give you a full sermon. Sometimes things happen that I have to just get rid of my sermon and go with something different. Today is a day when I really feel I want to address this, because it has been so difficult for us to gather together as a congregation. Yes, we have finally been able to have a congregational meeting, but I haven't been able to gather together to really address questions that people might have about going live. And this is something that I'm working on. I have been working on for what seems like forever throughout the pandemic, as the pandemic has waned and carried on. I realized that we need to be able to go live instead of spending so much of my time producing a worship video. Rather than being a producer, I'd like to be able to provide pastoral care beyond just emergency pastoral care. So this is something I feel strongly about. We need to go live. We need to be one community, worshiping together. And I'm so thankful that we're able, because of technology, because of this technology, we're able to reach people who are connected with us and connected with our congregation who are distant from us, who couldn't be here on Sunday morning in person. So we want them to be part of our worshiping community, fully part. That's just one of the whys. And there are many other whys, but this is something that I've been passionate about and something I've been working toward, and with help of the Mutual Ministry Committee and Congregation Council, Board of Stewardship and Finance, I've been working on this. So I have to realize that, of course, you all might not be fully aware that we are working on, might not have known that we were working toward going live until you receive the newsletter or the letter in the mail. And so I need to breathe. I need to realize that I just need to take a breath. And even though I hope, you know, my wildest dream would be that we would be able to have all of our cameras and everything in place to go live by Christmas Eve, I realize that the money may not flow in from this appeal for us to be able to gather together. Now, for us to be able to go live in time. Now, our congregation council cannot expend, this is according to our constitution and bylaws, our congregation council cannot expend any funds outside of what's been budgeted. And this is certainly not a budgeted expense, this going live. And we won't spend anything without bringing it to a meeting of the congregation for their vote to go ahead. The estimated cost of all this is between $15,000 and $20,000, and our low bid has come in at that, but our highest bid has been outside of that. The exact amount needed for the bid, though, that is selected for this project, we will have the bid in place and we'll have all the financing in place from support from all of our generous members and friends of the congregation. And if we have to, money from the interest from our endowment fund, if they are able to contribute, and our memorial fund. We'll have all that in place before we take it to the congregation. Now, of course, we are doing this going live appeal, without approval from the congregation, because also in the bylaws, it states that the Board of Stewardship and Finance can do appeals from time to time that are outside of the regular budget process. And so that's why we've gone about it this way, but we will not move forward without approval of the congregation, without meeting together as a congregation to answer your questions. On Sunday, I'm planning to stay after worship so that I can answer questions in person. Rather than greet people at the door, I'm going to stay in the sanctuary. If people have questions, I want to be able to address them personally about why I think it's important that we need to go live and what the process has been. And so once this is all in place, once we have all the funding lined up, then we'll have a congregational meeting and get your go-ahead. Until then, we'll keep talking and planning. So, and breathing. So please, keep sharing your questions and concerns with the members of our mutual ministry committee. That's a great group of people. I named who those folks are, but the mutual ministry committee is essentially a listening post to find so that I can hear from them. And they're all plugged into different parts of our congregation in different ways, some overlapping, but some in really different parts. So I'm able to hear from them what they are hearing. And it's called mutual ministry because it's about doing ministry together. We are not a governing body. They simply advise me. We advise each other on the best ways to move forward, and then things, if they need to become official, go to our congregation council or to a meeting of the congregation if whatever it is not provided for in our constitution. So please, breathe. That's advice for me more than it is for any of you. All of your questions and concerns are certainly legitimate. And I recognize that doing life together is not easy. Sometimes it's pretty messy. So don't stop sharing your questions and your concerns. Call me or any of those members of the Mutual Ministry Committee or even folks on our Congregation Council as we move forward together in God's mission, God's work that is done in, with, and through Bethlehem Evangelical Lutheran Church. That was a breath. So to say that breath is important, well, that's certainly an understatement. You can go without eating for a month or two. People can go without eating for a month or two and go without drinking any water for 3 to 4 days. Sometimes more if the person is not active. But how long can we live without breathing? Breath is the essence of life. In the second expanded creation story that we find in Genesis, This is how life begins for Adam, with the breath of God, the breath of life. In Hebrew, breath of God is Ruah Yahweh, breath of God, breath of life. God breathes into Adam, takes a lump of clay, forms it into a body, and breathes into his nostrils for Adam to gain full life. And Adam actually comes from the word, the Hebrew word Adama, which means red earth, like clay. And our first reading for today begins after God has breathed life into Adam and instructed him not to eat from, he could eat from anywhere in the garden except for the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, the forbidden fruit. God gives life to Adam and to every living creature, and then creates Eve as a partner, a helper. The Hebrew Bible does not say that God breathed into Eve, but Eve certainly, surely has and had the breath of life. Just breathe. There's a right way and a wrong way for us to breathe. Noses are for breathing. Mouths are for eating. And talking only if we have to or someone is paying us to talk. We're only supposed to breathe through our nose. And God breathed the breath of life into Adam's nostrils, not into his mouth. We can breathe through our mouths if we have to, but when we do breathe through our mouths, we take in air that is unfiltered, unhumidified, and unheated. It's a shock to the lungs to bring in air in that way. The breath of life comes through the nose. When we inhale through our nose, the air is purified, humidified, and heated. Heated almost, no matter how, if it's 40 degrees outside, it is heated well into the 70s by the time it reaches the lungs. And if it's warmer, it is entirely common that the breath, when it reaches your lungs, would be at full body temperature. And when it reaches the lungs, when the breath reaches the lungs, where it is then taken up into our bloodstream to nourish our bodies, reaches out to our very fingertips. So be nice to your lungs and breathe through your nose to receive the breath of life where God breathed. God breathed life into Adam. How is God breathing? How is God giving you life? God breathes life into us just as God breathed life into Adam. Our relationship with God, just as God gave life to Adam, our relationship with God is our most important life-giving relationship that we have. So how are you nurturing this loving, life-giving relationship? Well, to do that, just breathe. Amen. How is God giving you life? How are you nurturing your most life-giving relationships? And as you reflect on these questions, we sing One Bread, One Body. Now together we confess our faith in the one who always welcomes us as a little child, using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. And we continue in prayer.
Made children and heirs of God's promise, we pray for the church, the world, and all in need. Holy One, you have raised up faithful leaders throughout history. Empower those discerning a call to ministry, and all seminarians, especially Jason Mills, as he continues his studies at Gettysburg Theological Seminary, to become a new minister of your gospel. Be with our presiding bishop, Elizabeth Eaton, and our bishop, Craig Satterley, as they seek to inform and teach your holy word to all in their ministries. We pray today for St. Matthew Lutheran Church in Heron and their pastor, Reverend Leslie Nye, and our partners in ministry at Pine Ridge Reservation in South Dakota and our Baker neighborhood partners. Entrust them with your vision for a world living in peace and harmony, trusting in them to bring your words of love, mercy, and compassion to all those with whom they serve. Protect our LPD Community Police Officer Sam Candle as he goes about his duties of protecting and caring for our neighborhood. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we come to you today to ask for guidance and wisdom to help us restore and protect endangered species and preserve endangered lands. Cultivate us in a sense of wonder for the world you have created and a sense of duty to ensure that all of your creation is protected for future generations to enjoy. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You desire for us not to be alone and to live in community with one another. Strengthen bonds between nations and peoples and give our leaders the wisdom and courage to act on behalf of all peoples everywhere, to bring about peace and goodwill toward one another. We pray today for our men and women in uniform. Protect them from harm, Lord, as they serve to protect us from harm. We pray especially for Chris Brown, Tyler Barnes, Andrew Devine, Darian Doan, Carson Kozlowski, Joshua Kozlowski, Rusty Landry, Christopher Morgan, Ben Painter, Ryan Schiffner, Jake Sonnenberg, and Eric Wheeler. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You share in our experiences and struggles. Bless all who live with any mental or physical disability. Inspire our communities to reach out to all those who live in fear of being overlooked and to help all those who can no longer manage for themselves. We pray for those in our church family who are suffering from illness, injury, or disability. We pray especially for Shelby Waters, John Nelson, Yvonne Nelson, Rhoda Hunter, Ruth Ferguson, Marianne Allen, Virginia Bauman, Mary Brinke, Tasha Brisbow, Lois Carnes, Marv Cole, Crystal Collins, Doug Griffin, Emma Hicks, Amy Hunter, Marilyn Bass-Heiser, Nancy Jackson, Marilyn Kostruski, Michael Mahoney, Linda McClellan, Theron Palmer, John Ransom, Gloria Robbins, Carol Rausch, Audrey Skidmore, Cheryl Van Patten, and Matthew White. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, you promise eternal life to all your children. Thank you for the people of faith who have gone before us. Strengthen our trust we have in you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
And we pray for Johnny Lindstrom, Ashley Fernandez, Ginny Garatina, Wendy Prattley, Jim Miller, Matt Anderson, Caleb Crawford, and those we now name before you in our hearts. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You promise eternal life to all your children. Thank you for the people of faith who have gone before us. Strengthen us to trust you in all things. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Receive these prayers, O God, and those in our hearts known only to you, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Please greet one another with a word of God's peace and love. And as you do, we will receive our offering as well as a second offering for the Greater Lansing Food Bank and our food pantry. Thank you for your support of that ministry and the entire support of your ministry, your entire support of the ministry of Bethlehem Evangelical Lutheran Church. And as we receive those offerings, please enjoy members of our choir singing Day by Day.
Let us pray. Our gratitude for life and its gifts overflows. O Lord, into the giving of ourselves, what we have, and what we are. Take these gifts we offer and use them to bless others. Then make us the type of people who are always looking for ways to share in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Gathered as one in the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. And the Holy Trinity, one God, bless you now and forever. Amen. And we sing, Go, My Children, with My Blessing. Go in peace, serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.